Maybe see it. Good evening. Friends and family, we have come together to witness the joining of Matthew of the National. This is a special time and celebration of Matthew and Kelly's long remembrance. And because of this, they are thankful that you are here to share their joy. We are here not only to witness your commitment to each other, but also to wish you both every happiness in your future life together as husband and wife. Marriage is a supreme sharing, perhaps the greatest and most challenging adventure in the most intimate of human relationships. It is the joyful uniting of two individuals whose care and affection and understanding have flowered into a deep and abiding love. Those who take its vows have their lives blended together into one, as the waters of two rivers are joined when they come together to form a paradise. Marriage is not a place to hide from the world. It's a safe place to grow and become wiser. It's a place to evolve into better people so that you can go out in the world and make a difference by spreading the joy and wisdom that you have found with each other. Marriage is the beginning of a new life, a chance of fulfilling long-held dreams, an opportunity for great personal and spiritual growth. Marriage continues to live as a promise of a beautiful dream to come true. As long as individuals are drawn together by that dream, marriage will be the natural and wholesome relationship. No ceremony can create a marriage. Only you can do that through love, patience, dedication, perseverance through talking and listening, and trying to understand through helping and supporting and believing in each other, through learning to forgive. Learning to respect and appreciate your differences, and learning to make the important things matter and let go of the rest. What this ceremony can do is to witness and affirm the choice you have made to begin a new life today as husband and wife. Keeping that in mind, falling in love is like owning a dog. First of all, it's a big responsibility. So think long and hard before deciding on love. On the other hand, love gives you a sense of security when you're walking down the street late at night and you have a leash on love, ain't no one gonna mess with you because crooks and muggers think love is unpredictable. Who knows what love can do in its own defense? On cold winter nights, love is warm. It lies between you and lives and breathes and makes funny noises. Love wakes you up at all hours at night. With its needs, it needs to be fed so it will grow and stay healthy. Love does not like being left alone long. But come home, and love is always happy to see you. It may break a few things accidentally in its passion for life, but you can never be mad at love for long. Is love good all the time? No, it's not. Love can be bad, very bad, very bad love. Love makes messes. Love leaves you little surprises here and there. And love leaves not lots of cleaning up after. Sometimes you want to get love fixed. Sometimes you want to roll up a piece of newspaper and swat love on the nose. Not so much to cause a pain, but just to let love know, don't ever do that again. Sometimes love just wants to go out for nice long walks because love loves exercise. It runs you around the block. It pulls you in several different directions at once, or winds around and around until you're all wound up and can't move. But love makes you meet people wherever you go. People who have nothing in common but love stop and talk to each other on the street. Throw things away and love will bring them back again and again and again. But most of all, love needs love, lots of it. And in return, love loves you and never stops. Have you come here freely, without reservation, to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for as long as you both show it?
Yes.
The circle has long been a symbol for marriage. These circles are made of precious metal to represent the precious nature of your relationship. Being unbroken circles, each represents unending love. As often as either of you look upon them, may you be reminded of this moment and the love you have promised. Now, Kelly, please acknowledge your intent. You take this man for your lawful wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, as long as you both shall live. If so, please answer right here. Now, Matthew, please acknowledge your intent for Kelly. Do you take this woman for your lawful wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, as long as you both shall live?
Yeah.
By your free choice, you've made a marriage. No matter what the demands in your lives and your time, the meaning of your living is now known through your love. You must nurture each other to fullness and fullness. Renew yourselves in love and laughter. Maintain the capacity for wonder, spontaneity, humor, sensitivity, and above all, save time for each other. Before this gathering, Matthew and Kelly promised each other their undying love and exchanged rings to wear as a sign of their everlasting commitment to each other. By the power vested in them, I now pronounce you the husband of your wife. Matthew, you may kiss your bride.